Welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. We are living in an instantaneous age where what happens in Iraq, the minute it happens, we know in Boston. Well, that is happening all over the world, but is it happening where you work? Is it happening that on Wall Street, people who are facing terrible moments of economic depression are suddenly hiding things because they think it won't be found out? Well, my guest today, Warren Bennis, has co-authored with Daniel Goleman, James O'Toole, and Patricia Ward Biederman a book called Transparency: How Leaders Create a Culture of Candor. And it is published by Jossie Bass. Welcome, Warren.
Good to be here, Connie.
Can you be transparent in an era of such horrible economic news?
It's not even a question of can you be, it's a question of you must be, because there's no hiding. And transparency is inevitable. But there's a tune from the movie and the play, Chicago,
mm-hmm.
and there's a character in it called Cellophane Man.
Yeah.
Remember that sort of song? Well, you can't be Cellophane Man or woman, but in these days, even if you thought you didn't want to be, you'd have a hard time not being. Tom Friedman was saying recently, he was in an airport, and some, you know, shabbily dressed but tough guy edged his way in front of him while he was waiting to get to the seat, meet with the ticket taker, and just pushed his way in. And, you know, Friedman felt like he wanted to push him back. He said, no, there's someone around with a camcorder, and I'll be exposed as a thug.
Yeah.
You cannot, what can you keep secret now? In today's New York Times, front page, a blogger, a military blogger, a colonel, discovered a piece of information that was relevant to a recent Supreme Court decision, 5-4, Justice Kennedy wrote the lead decision about whether or not child rape is a capital offense. And they ruled it unconstitutional because it wasn't. And just a blog today, and there are 180 million bloggers doing their work as we talk, 180 million.
Where do they find the time is what I'm curious about.
A lot of them have nervous breakdowns.
I mean,
a lot of the people who work full-time for blogging organizations like Squawk.com mm-hmm. are many reported to have very bad stress having just to deal with
keeping up.
Yeah.
But you started to say, I'm sorry, I did not mean to interrupt you, about the Supreme Court and what was constitutional.
Mm-hmm. And here's a case which they passed and will probably not review about the fact that it was a federal piece of legislation and a federal executive order that made it constitutional.
Yeah.
And that fact was unknown. Now, by the way, I agreed with the court decision. That's not the point. The point is, in this case, the fact is that bloggers keep revealing truths that we should know about, should have been warned about, and sometimes surprise us.
You coined the word, I understand, organizational culture.
I didn't, but I was one of the early...
How much does an organization mirror the rest of the country?
It's hard to know. I think more and more organizations are more tried to rule by the sunshine law rather than by closing it down. And given all the blogs within companies, how can you not be?
Yeah.
I mean, now the extent, but I think there's a contradiction here because in the last 8 years, and I think a lot more will come out, and this is a political statement, but I don't mean it politically. In the last 8 years, when our national government executive people, I'm talking about Bush mm-hmm. Cheney, have really tried to get rid of habeas corpus, when they've made surveillance of domestic people on phone companies, for example,
mm-hmm.
allowable, I think there's really a disconnect between what I see going on in organizations today, which are trying to be more transparent and more open, because I don't think they have much choice. Whereas, contradictorily, our national government has, I think, over the last 8 years, done pretty much the opposite.
Well, you mention in the book how much is classified now so that it's not available to the public.
Mm-hmm. Well, President Bush has said, I will decide what's classified or not.
Yeah.
His words.
Yeah.
So I think I do think that more and more, however, I think the government is going to have to take more into account. I mean, the first blogger famously was Matt Drudge, who revealed the affair. Was it really an affair? I don't know. I'm not going to like Mr. Clinton argue about words.
Yeah.
But it was the Monica relationship, which the Drudge Report in 1998 made public. So more and more of these bloggers are going to make keeping things in the public more and more difficult.
I also appreciate the fact you talk about integrity and trust, and the other third important word, truth.
Right, all three. Yeah. Yeah. And if you look at all the surveys on what people are looking for in our national leaders, those three words will come up. Those three words come up often number one in surveys. Number two is competence.
Yeah.
So if you bring integrity, authenticity, truth with competence, I think you've probably got a winning national ticket.
If you have a company, and there is, you're in the company, you're on the third tier, you're not even close to the top man or woman, you see what's going wrong. Let's talk about whistleblowers, because it's like nobody appreciates the tattletale.
No, and I'd go beyond that.
Yeah.
Remember the cover of Time magazine? Must have been 5 or 6 years ago.
Yeah.
Three women. They were the so-called women of the year. I don't remember all of their names, but Watkins from Enron was one of them. Cheryl Watkins. There was a woman from the FBI was another one. It was interesting to me, first of all, about gender to begin with on that particular issue. Why was it that there were three women who were the whistleblowers? Number one, when you said appreciated, they're not just not appreciated. They're usually disowned.
Yeah.
And suffer a great deal, usually fired.
Well, you mentioned who Donald Provance in the book, who ends up in where? In Germany, in a sense, demoted.
Yes. I think this is... Now, the federal government has tried to pass laws on protecting the whistleblower, but how do we get to make whistleblowers irrelevant? See, that's what we're trying to talk about in the book. How do we... You know, the whole idea of... Your question is terrific, because most of us are at the third level of an organization.
Yeah.
Maybe we're lower or higher. You know, how many levels of a bureaucracy do we have? In the university, we're relatively lucky, but even there, there are things going on that are a mystery to us.
Which means enter the blogger, because suddenly you, as a whistleblower, can put it out to the world without saying, I'm telling you, it's my name on
yes,
it.
Yes, right.
Yeah.